Yo, what up, YouTube? This is Damnation, and you're probably wondering why I'm stumbling around in the dark of the woods. Not because of the pretty lady slippers, but because of one thing. What is this? Mushrooms. Morale mushrooms. Now, it just rained in here in Minnesota, and about 1 o'clock it's supposed to get warmer. But I'm running around in the dark. The reason being I'm running around in the dark is because in the area where I'm hunting mushrooms at, other people hunt here. But there's only like me and two other people that know about, this. Now, one of the people over-harvested the area pretty freaking bad, like really bad. Like, the last 5 years have just been terrible in the woods where I'm at right now. And then the other person doesn't help it. You know, three people in a small... I mean, you probably watched the wooded... Or me walking around talking about gamers and... Gamers. And gamers and players. And, yeah, this woods isn't that big for three people to be harvesting mushrooms. And the numbers have dropped dramatically, like I said, in the last 5 years. So I'm out here, running around in the dark, looking at mushrooms, and I found these. Lady slippers, which is the state flower of Minnesota. But, I'll come back and I'll show you some mushrooms as soon as I find some more. Alright, welcome back, and I actually found one. It's, I can get the scale to show up. You can get the scale. It's about an inch and a half. Yeah, that's what I'm out here doing. Got my knife. Mushroom knife. Okay, so if anybody out there is new to morale hunting, alright, don't pick it, alright? If you have a knife, flashlight doesn't want to stay away. If you have a knife, that'd be the best way to do it. But you take it at the edge of the thing, or at the edge of the stem, and you cut it at the edge of the stem. So you leave this right here. This is the bottom of the mushroom. This is where the root is. And the next rain and next warmth, this will actually grow back into another one of these. So then you just, after you get done cutting it, you put it back in your bag. Now, if you're wondering where I got all these other mushrooms, started making the video. And now, where you find one, you'll find more. So if you find one, you stay in that area and you look all around in the area, the grass, and you don't stop looking. You look in all the area, because where there's one, there's more. I'll get back to you when I find another. See what I mean when I... See what I mean? When there's one, there's more. And that's not that far from where we found the other one. It is right over there. Right over there. That's where I found the other one. So there might be... maybe two or three more. Who knows? Maybe more. But... this guy off the ground here. Now, everyone, like, some people will toss up the grass. See all the leaves and stuff like that. Some people will toss up all the leaves. I don't. I leave the leaves there because why disturb the area for mushroom? Oops, sorry. Hey, look. See right there? See, there's another one right there. I didn't even see that one until I was talking to you guys. So yeah, there might be a few more about here. I'm gonna get these cut out, and I'll get back to you as soon as I just found another one from right view, whatever's from where I found the one, and then the two over there. I just found this one. Take a look around. So I don't tear up the brush. It's actually a lot harder at night to do this. Probably another one right there. Yep. It's actually a lot harder to do this at night during the day. But, you know, like I said in my whatever, this area doesn't get hit hard as much as the other side, or other side of the, so, I don't know if you guys can see that, but on this, right in that, towards that area, where the flashlight is, are tons of buckthorn, and I don't think this area gets picked over much, because I don't think people want to go through the buckthorn just to get over here, but, I'm going to get this guy cut up, and I'm going to look for more, and when I do, I'll show you.
Alright.
Alright, I'm out back, and this is where I found the one. And right over here, I almost stepped on that one. There's another one. Now, if you look really close, there's one right there. And that's less than an inch. I don't actually pick those size. Bring my scale here. See this, my scale? So this stands, my knuckle is exactly 1 inch. So it stands at 1.5 inches. And I don't actually pick those. But the people that come out here actually pick these. And these are what the next generation is. So, I mean, if you pick these, you're not going to get these big ones. And the root, and you'll kill off under what's underneath, which is the roots and stuff. So, but yeah, I almost stepped on this one from right there. Right there, that's almost 2 feet. Yeah, it's about 2 feet. So yeah, so I think I'm on it now. There's some, I don't know if you can see that, right there, two right there. So I'm in it now. So there might be more than just these ones that I've been finding. So I'll get back to you. I might as well take my knife. See, now these, that's 1 inch. Each of them are like 1 inch. So I'll take those ones, because they're big enough to take. And I'm going to cut those ones out, and I'll get back to you as soon as I find some more.
I got another one, and there's a little
snail running up on that one. So like I said, so if you're out here if you're out hunting for morels and stuff like that, look for that kind of stuff. I think that's ash. Buckthorn, prickly ash, you know, there's milf, I can't remember what that's called. Yeah, they grow, they love that stuff. They grow thick and that kind of stuff. You know, there's some thorny stuff. But yeah, there's usually great places to look. So look at that, right there. Two of them, three of them. A little one hiding on the edge of that one. So I'm in it. I'm in a good spot for more owls, and I'm gonna pick what I can and get out of here, and probably, if I can't find any more, I'll probably start hanging into the buckthorn. The other day, a guy was out there and he found 20 of them. So it just rained, and I could always look for more. If I find any more. If you don't know what these ones are blonde ones. Now, there's two types of morels. There's blonde and grays. The grays are typically smaller. They run about maybe 3 or 4 inches. These blonde ones, if you let them go, they can grow up to be about the size of 16-ounce can. Yeah, they get pretty big. I think grays can get that size too, but I'm not sure. I've always seen them about maybe 3 to 4 inches tall. And that's, they're not like round, they're skinny. But these blonde ones, they get, you know, pretty big. They get about the size of a 16-ounce can, tall wise, and width wise, they get about that too. Sometimes they grow bigger. You know, since we're in the Midwest, that's basically where morels grow. You got Michigan, Wisconsin, I don't know where else. Michigan, Wisconsin, and Minnesota. If they grow somewhere else, it's cool. Yeah, probably Ohio and stuff like that. But yeah, I've seen Michigan ones get twice that size, and basically as big as that, round as that tree right there, and big too. So yeah, morels. Right there is one of the reasons why Walking at night sucks. I almost walked into that. So that would have sucked because I would have had a little bit of spider on my face. And yeah, it's not good. But yeah, so after I got done showing you the one mushroom that I, or the two mushrooms that I found four more. So now I'm going to go into the dreaded buckthorn or prickly ash or evil friggin' spiky trees, mini trees. But hopefully I'll find some in there and I'll get back to you when I do. All right, everybody. Well, there's my first in the buckthorn, and you know what buckthorn is? Yeah, that's buckthorn. It's all over the place. I mean, it literally is all over the place, and it friggin' sucks to walk through. But yeah, these ones right here, these blondes, they love the buckthorn, or prickly ash, or whatever you want to call it. And yeah, if you're looking for morels, or that's where the majority of the blonde ones are going to be. And so I'm going to cut this one, look for more, and I'll let you know. Alright, I just found my second one in the buckthorn, and I'm pretty deep in it. So yeah, I'm gonna keep looking and hopefully I find some more. I've been in here for a good almost 2 hours now, almost 3 hours, going on three. And you know, I got that much, I don't know how many are in there, I lost count. But yeah, you know, 3 hours, and you know, you find maybe maybe half a dozen or so. That's morale hunting for you. If I find any more, I'll let you know. I'm probably not gonna stay in here very long because I don't want to sit in the buckthorn all the time. So this might be my last mushroom for the night. And there's one more from the buckthorn. And I'm pretty in the thick of it. It's pretty far from where I found the last one. But that one is, that one's a good size. That one's about, two and a half inches big. That's a pretty nice size one. Hoping there's more of them in the area. And you know, if not, that, you know, again, that might be my last mushroom. Who knows? Alright, so yeah, that was my last one. And check out the spoils. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 26 mushrooms in 3 hours. It's not too bad. But yeah, so hope you enjoyed my night morale hunting, and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks for watching.